I didn't back down because I'm a Christian, I'm American, and I'm not gonna back down from a mob who tries to tell me what to think. My name is Reagan Eskede. I'm 22 years old and I'm from Shreveport, Louisiana. I noticed a trend within the evangelical church and a lot of leaders and pastors who are straying from the true gospel. And I had it on my heart to share from a biblical perspective on how we as Christians should be approaching the Black Lives Matter movement. I really went into detail about the movement and about how as Christians we should not be using secular narratives to find a resolution that's a spiritual problem. It's not a worldly problem. And here we are prescribing worldly solutions to a spiritual problem. And so I made a video addressing all of this and it went viral. I received a lot of backlash for it. The mob of leftists really did not agree with it. It didn't sit well with them. People began contacting my boss and harassing my employer, making threats to the owners of the company that I worked for, and they came to the conclusion to terminate my employment with the company and to fire me. It didn't come from a place of people wanting to educate me or to have a debate with me or a conversation. It was more, we don't like you, we don't like your views, check it off my list, you're done. It's been a roller coaster of emotions, I think. I was disappointed, but I also knew God had a purpose in this, and I knew His name was being glorified through this. Regardless of what, you know, the mob thought, I always knew that Christ's name will be glorified in the end. I knew that God had put it on my heart to share that message, and I knew it was a message that was of the silent majority. It wasn't a message that was the mainstream. And so, as hard as it was to face the backlash, and as hard as it was to face the harassment, I have just as much of a freedom of speech and a freedom of opinion as anyone else does. And just because someone tells me I'm wrong and that I'm awful for feeling the way that I do doesn't mean I need to change my opinion to submit to them and gain approval. My approval doesn't come from the world. My approval comes from God. And that's the only approval that I should be seeking and that we should be seeking as Christians. And so it makes me wonder, okay, what is this path that the left is trying to get us to follow? And why is it okay in one situation, but not okay in another? And so when we have people like me or like you who are conservative Christians and find it important to empower young people and important to speak the truth, we shouldn't back down and hesitate from the truth because people are hungry for the truth. I'm not backing down from the mob just because they disagree. Why would I submit? Why would I let them win? When I know what I'm speaking is truth, when I know what I'm speaking is powerful and is life-changing, it's not worth it. We're not called to be like the world. We're not called to be like the world. We're called to be like Christ. To the people who wanted to cancel me and make me viral, you made me viral and you made my voice louder.